We've been told for decades that stress is really bad for us. It's bad for our health, for our well-being, and even for our work performance. And there's a good reason to believe this is true. There's a lot of scientific evidence suggesting that stress can be bad. But some more recent research is suggesting that we haven't had a full picture of actually how stress works and how we can manage it more effectively. It's first important just to note that stress is a very adaptive thing that our body does. It's something that we evolved in order to be ready for action. When you feel your heart pounding and your palms sweating and your breathing rate going up, that's actually your body's way of helping you to survive in that moment, preparing you to fight for your life or run away from something dangerous, right? And one of the things that we've learned from recent research is that people who believe that stress isn't necessarily bad, but in fact something that can help them, seem to be better off. In many ways, this belief that stress can actually be helpful seems to protect you against the potentially negative effects of stress. So for example, in some research that I've done, we taught students the night before a first midterm exam that their feelings of anxiety about the test could actually help them. And we found that giving students that simple message actually led them to do better on their exam the next day and in the course as a whole. Our research is also teaching us that not all stress is the same. We encounter some stressful things in our lives that we can control. So for example, if I'm experiencing stress about a big test, I can control that. I can do things to study and to be more prepared. But we also experience stress that comes from things that we cannot control. So if I've already taken a big test, for example, and I have to wait a week to get my results, I may be feeling stressed about how I did, but I can't do anything about that stress. I can't take action. So is stress bad for you? I think the answer is it doesn't have to be. We just need to be smarter about the ways that we think about our stress, understanding when we can use our stress to mobilize ourselves to action, and when, on the other hand, we need to use our stress as a signal that it's time to reach out and ask for some help and some support.